Hi, I am Valder Beebe. I am the host and the visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
Asking myself, who wouldn't want to look at that?
Who didn't want the smiley face?
Hi, Sinqua Walls and Kelly Price.
Hi.
Hi, welcome to the live broadcast of the Valder Beebe Show.
You know what?
Thank you.
Are you Valder? Are we talking to you right now? You have
You're
the most amazing name. You have the name of a superstar.
Well, thank you so much.
I feel like I need to be seeing like a marquee that says starring Valder Beebe.
I definitely could see that.
Yes. Thank you. From your, as they say, from your lips to God's ears.
I'm so serious.
We'll go with that.
You're
such a megastar, Kelly Price, and Sinqua Walls. You get to create this great work. I'm so glad you're here today to talk about your latest project.
Yes.
If I could start with Kelly, because women are always first in my world.
Ah.
Mine too.
Yeah.
That's another topic for another day.
Yeah, I usually don't get any blow pushback on that. Kelly, what's going on with your latest project? I love it, but I'm going to let you tell my audience about
it. Yes, absolutely. So you're talking to me because I am a series regular in the wonderful new television show, American Soul, which recounts the life of the late, great, legendary Don Cornelius and how he built the Soul Train empire against the backdrop of the height of the civil rights movement and war and the draft, and deciding that as a black man he wanted to, for the first time, present our beautiful culture, the colors of it, the greatness of it, the loudness of it, the boldness of it, but not just present it, but own it. And my role in this is that I am the matriarch of the Clark family. My children are two of the original Soul Train dancers. They're a singing group trying to use this opportunity to get their foot in the door to have the singing careers that they want to have. And you'll see my family go through a lot of personal changes. We experience great loss. And Brianna's on a journey of finding herself as a black woman in America during those times, with teen children and having a husband who is off at war and trying to hold the family together and back in school and, you know, just being all the things that we knew strong black women to be during those times and even now. And so my storyline with my family is representative of the black household during that era.
So impressive.
Thank you
so much for sharing.
Thank you.
Okay. Mr. Sinqua, let's hear how you stepped into the shoes of Don Cornelius, because all of us sitting at home watching Soul Train, we feel like we know him.
Right. I think that was the biggest thing, is understanding that Don was a man that did exist. So number one, stepping in humbly and knowing that when you're telling someone's story and you want to tell it authentically, you have to honor the presence to which they existed with. My first step was really sitting down with his son, Tony Cornelius, talking to him in depth about what his life was like being raised by his father, who became this iconic man. And then taking those stories and using them to mold into my own energy of what I wanted to see the character become. So that was the first step. Then there's a lot of reading, there's a lot of research, you know, going all the way back to when he was at DuSable High and understanding what streets did he live on, you know, who were the people that he interacted with when he was walking as a kid, what made him marry Dolores so young, what was their relationship like, because that fuels the mentality of a man. So when you sit down, you start to, you know, jot out your backstory and do your research, you begin there and you just let it all fill in and make sure you're being spontaneous in the moment. But really it started with Tony. And I always say this in every interview, that I'm so grateful for him because he opened up his treasure chest of information being raised by his father, and that helped me really dive into that character.
And trust me, everybody says, oh, what was it like to act? I tell everybody everywhere, we're gonna mean this with the sincerity of my heart, there was not a day that Sinqua came on set and acted like Don Cornelius. He became Don Cornelius, and you will see that. We lost him at some points. Even when we weren't shooting, we would be looking at him going, come back to us, come back to us.
I would lose myself at times, too.
What a great compliment from one of your stars.
He's amazing.
That's just when an actor loves an actor. That's really
I do.
And the feeling is mutual. I think like this woman right here is a gift. We all know that. And I think what's the gift of her talent, but the gift of her person is so much greater. So for her to say it, she means it, and it means so much more to me because I know it's emphatic. And I just always want to highlight that because I think we have a perspective and we have the brand, Kelly, that everyone knows. But I think through your acting, now we're going to meet the woman that is Kelly, as I've been able to meet on so many personal levels.
Yes. Thank you.
Kelly, you're in such a place. You've had such an evolution. You've had such a journey, like everyone does. But yours plays out a lot in the public, and there's a lot we don't see.
Yeah.
But you're going to be working with Gladys Knight, I heard, and Kelly Rowland, and other stars who shine as brightly. How does this help you, who's a consummate professional?
Oh, gosh. You know, I have to honestly say that my journey hasn't been an easy one, but it's been an incredible one. I feel like God really blessed me to put me in the presence of people who are great at what they do. So I've learned from the best. I did learn from Sean Puffy Combs. I did learn from Mariah Carey. I did learn from Ronald Isley, who saw in me what I didn't see in myself and insisted, Kelly, you will make records. Don't let the industry tell you that you're not good enough, you don't fit the bill because you don't look like this girl over here. And so I was raised by, I feel like, the best. And doors opened. I was able to write for a lot of people. But making this transition, and you're right, my life did play out publicly. I was married. I was raising kids at the time, trying to keep a career together. In the last 4 years, I've lost a sibling. I've gotten divorced after 24 years of marriage. And so what I do love about that is that people who live every day, quote, regular lives, have an opportunity to see someone who may be going through something hard, but can see that it's also possible to walk it out graciously and with grace and with compassion. And that coming out on the other side victorious is really possible.
American Soul on BET. And you've got two of the greatest stars here. My audience is just loving this. They're going crazy on Facebook.
Thank you.
You're really talking to Kelly Price. I can't believe it. Oh, Sinqua, I can't believe that.
Ain't he fun, y'all?
Hey.
They wouldn't even give me any scenes. Let me tell y'all how dirty they did me. I had one scene with them all season, and it was literally just looking at him like some dirty old lady telling about, oh, he's fine.
Well, really? Sinqua, I loved you in Clint Eastwood biopic, the 1517 to Paris. You did a great job, so thanks so much for being here. Kelly, when can we watch you on BET American Soul?
Oh, my God. You can watch us beginning February 5th. That is Tuesday. That is in less than 2 weeks. And do not move. I want people to have watch parties. Don't move, because we're coming to you twice in one night. We're giving you episode 1 and episode 2 in the first night. And believe you me, it is epic. It's going to change everything you thought you knew about this man.
We're gonna be there, and thank you so much for gracing the Valder Beebe Show and exciting my audience early this morning.
Well,
I really appreciate it.
Thank you for having us.
Having us.